Talk to me about a little bit about the jumper rallies and how it got started here at Somerset and just the influence it's had on the soccer programs.
Jumper rallies probably started, I'm going to say, 4 or 5 years ago. Just a group of seniors that just started acting crazy at games, having fun, turning into a big fun atmosphere event type thing, more than just sitting there watching the games. And since then, it's gotten better and better every year with the seniors. We had a great senior class last year, and we were kind of concerned about, you know, we're going to have that kind of turnout again. And it seems like every year a class steps up and takes over and gets everybody out. They have theme nights every time we have a game, whether it's football, basketball, soccer. And so that's kind of the evolution, probably been about 4 or 5 years ago, and just keeps getting stronger and stronger every year.
Beside the X's and O's and the fundamentals, you know, part of your job is trying to get your kids motivated. How big is this as far as taking care of that part? It sort of takes part of that job away from you.
It's huge. It's huge. Kids love it. You know, we've been on the road 5 games. We finally got to come to home game. I knew the enthusiasm. I wasn't going to worry about motivation. I knew they were going to love playing in front of the crowd. They've got a couple years ago, they said, we do a chant before the game. And the kids, my soccer kid says, can we go over and do it with our fans? That's how much they appreciate doing that. So every game they come over and we do a pregame chant with our student section, and the students love it.
And every time somebody scores a goal, they usually get love from that section.
It's crazy. They come over and they'll get love from the fans. They get their little music blaring and, you know, their theme song if they score. And you know, like I said, it's turned into a big event. Every home game is like a huge event for the Jumper Rowdies. They plan it. They get numbers out. It's something pretty special here. We don't see that anywhere else in the state. And I've coached several years, I've never seen it anywhere like this.
So, to go on that point, how many years have you coached or been part of soccer, and you've probably been to probably almost every soccer place in the state? Has anything compared to this?
I've never seen anything. Covenant Catholic would be the only thing even remotely close to it.
How many years?
So I've been coaching, I guess, 17 years. So, with this, that being said, I've been to pretty much every venue there is to play at. Covenant Catholic's the only one that would even remotely come close to what we do here. And it's still about the way.
Sitting in my basement and started talking about how we need a bigger student section and we need to do something about it. And we decided to create a Twitter page called the BJN Rowdies, Briar Jumper Nation Rowdies. And once that started, we started tweeting about games and getting all of the high schoolers to follow our page and to get them word on when the game times are so they can get here for the games. And then we started creating themes and started generating a lot of people in our sections, and it started getting crazy, and it went up from there, and that's about it.
Talk about last night, and this is the first home game season. Was y'all sort of blown away by what happened as far as the amount of people showed up and all the hot tub and the big inflatables? Talk a little bit about that.
Well, as Coach Wallace was saying, he said that 170 kids showed up, which is just incredible for the size of our school. And seeing so many kids have school spirit for the soccer team and supporting them, it's just incredible.
All right, thanks guys.
We talk a lot about what sets Somerset apart in a lot of ways, traditions and our history and just a unique product we have here. One of those is our school spirit and the impact and the engagement that our students have with our sports teams. And it's not just football or basketball. We'll have sometimes 50 to 100 students here for a volleyball game cheering the girls on. Obviously the soccer game that we had last night, about 170 students we counted were here, and they're having fun, they're cheering for the team. They're not cheering against the other team. They're having fun with each other, they're engaging with each other, and we really promote that. That's something that we are very proud of and excited about. It's totally student generated and ran. We don't have an official pet club here. The students do it all. They're on Twitter, they're on Facebook. They will hashtag things, they'll put group messages out. And they're appropriately named the BJN Rowdies, and from our hashtag, the Pride of Our Nation. So it is a very unique thing. We're very proud of it, very excited about it, and just makes another reason that I say here every day, it's a great day to be a Pride jumper.
And now you've been in the education system for a while, and you've been to different schools.
I have.
And soccer usually is sort of a calm, few parents type. Yes. And how special is that for the kids to embrace this as far as the soccer? And it talks about the success of the soccer program, sure, too, here at Somerset.
It's very impressive. This is my 27th year. I've been at three different high schools, and it is very unique. And so, like I said, it's not just football or basketball. They're going to do this for girls' soccer, boys' soccer, obviously volleyball. And they'll come to girls' basketball games. And so it is just something that we want to promote, that we invest in every student, every sport, every activity, and make sure that our students know that as well. And obviously, if you come to our sporting events, you're going to see that that's what we're about, and that it's student done. They just simply invite us to be a part of it, and we look back and still smile that's what makes Somerset a great place to be.